Let us now analyze the concept of jihad in Islam.
Peaceful peace.
To learn any meaning of the word, one would search the dictionary, not the newspaper, not the website, not the magazine, not any paper. We search for the right word to get the real meaning, the dictionary. And the best and the most authentic dictionary for Islamic terminologies is the Glorious Quran. And the Glorious Quran, it defines the word, the term jihad, which comes out from the root word al-juhdu, which means to make an effort, to strive, to struggle, and to fight with complete dedication against all kinds of evil, against all kind of injustice, destruction, and persecution. Many people have a misconception that jihad means holy war, which is very wrong. It's a wrong notion. The word, the Arabic word for holy war is harbul muqaddasa, not jihad. Many people, they have a misconception that jihad means terrorism. They fail to realize that jihad is a war against terrorism. Jihad is a war against terrorism to curb it, to wipe it out, to eradicate all kinds of destruction and persecution. For the better understanding, if we analyze Islam as a whole, that is the Glorious Quran and the authentic sayings of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, we may very well conclude that jihad can be done against four enemies. Jihad can be done against four enemies, two non-human and two human. Number one, jihad on nafs, meaning striving against our own self, and jihad us shaitan, meaning doing jihad or striving against our own shaitan, against our own evil which exists within us. And the third one is jihad us zalimin, that is struggling against the oppressors. And the fourth one is jihad, that is striving against the hypocrites, against the disbelievers. Let us analyze the first type of jihad, or the first enemy whom we have to do jihad. Jihad on nafs. It means to strive, to struggle against our own selfish desires. Allah Bari Ta'ala says in Surah Nisa, Surah number 4, Ayat number 135. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe, stand firmly for justice. Stand firmly for justice. Even the justice goes against your own self, against your own parents, against your own relatives. Stand firmly for justice. Moreover, when we read the Glorious Quran, in Surah Shams, Surah number 91, Ayat number 10, 9 and 10, it says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَا زَكَّاهَا. He is indeed successful who purifies his own soul, and he is indeed in failure who injures his own soul. Let us analyze the second enemy to whom we have to do jihad with. That is jihad us shaitan. It means to strive, to struggle against our own evil which exists within us. Allah Bari Ta'ala says in Surah Baqara, Surah number 2, Ayat number 168. Innahu lakum aduwwu mubin. Most certainly, Satan, Shaitan, is your open enemy, which misguides you, which leads you to the path of destruction. And Allah says, do jihad against that enemy. That is jihad us shaitan. Coming to the third heading, that is jihad us zalimin, that is striving against the oppressors, and jihad ul munafiqin wal kafirin, that is striving against the hypocrites and the disbelievers. There are two ways or two methods to do jihad, to fight against these two enemies. First is the permanent and the unconditional method, and the second is the temporary and the conditional method. Let us analyze the first method, that is permanent and unconditional method. It means jihad bil lisan, doing jihad, striving with the tongue, practicing, promoting and clarifying the things about Islam is known as jihad bil lisan, that is striving with the tongue. Allah Bari Ta'ala, He loves the person who does the work of da'wah, that is inviting, presenting Islam and sharing Islam with people, as Allah testifies in the glorious Quran in Surah Fussilat, Surah number 41, ayah number 33. Allah Bari Ta'ala says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَامِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Meaning, who is better in speech than one who calls men to Allah, does righteous deeds, and says, I am of those who bow down to none but Allah. Further, Allah Bari Ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Furqan, Surah number 25, Ayah number 52, فَلَا تُطِعِ الْكَافِرِينَ وَجَاهِدْهُمْ بِهِ جِهَادًا كَبِيرًا. So, O Prophet, do not obey the disbelievers and strive with the glorious Quran. This is the greatest striving. Let us analyze the temporary and the conditional method of jihad. It means jihad bisayf, doing jihad, strive.